Our next presenter is Miranda Medrano, College of Veterinary Medicine, Veterinary Medicine PhD program.
To begin, I'm going to tell a little story about the history of pigs in America. Pigs were first introduced to the continent by Hernando de Soto in 1539, where pigs were largely free-range and thrived with little human input, until the 18th century when the confinement of pigs in pens began. Throughout the late 1900s, the U.S. swine industry would see an overall decrease in the number of pig farms, but an increase in the number of pigs per farm. And in order for this to happen, indoor facilities were necessary, as indoor pigs were easier to manage, meant less land use, less labor, and the opportunity to be raised year-round, especially in colder climates like Minnesota. By the 1990s, 81% of all U.S. pig farms had at least one confinement building. Today, despite this increase of indoor pig farms, there are still some farmers who purposely raise their pigs with outdoor access. They do this for many reasons, including improved animal welfare, environmental sustainability, and the opportunity to sell locally through farmers markets and co-ops. Unfortunately, though, due to the fewer numbers of pigs raised with outdoor access, these farms have largely been ignored by the U.S. veterinary industry, meaning that the health status of their pigs and their farming practices are fairly unknown. Which led to my research question: does raising pigs with outdoor access lead to an increase in disease frequency when compared to pigs that are raised indoors? To answer this question, I identified over 200 pig farms in Minnesota that raise pigs with outdoor access, sent these farmers a survey, and even visited a few of them to test their pigs for a few diseases. From this, I learned that one farm had as few as 4 pigs, and another that had over 500 pigs. I learned that nearly 1/3 of them had never consulted with the veterinarian. And for the farms that I tested, only 35% tested positive for a disease that is wreaking havoc in farms that raise their pigs indoors. The results of this survey suggests that outdoor pig farms do differ in their farming practices and the types of diseases that their pigs might encounter. This highlights the importance of veterinarians and the veterinary industry in addressing the specific concerns of outdoor pig farms, as keeping pigs healthy is important not only for the pigs, but also for the health of the environment, the farmers, and for the consumer like you, especially since pork and bacon should really be its own food group. Going forward, I plan on using mathematical modeling to identify specific farming practices that might lead to an increase in disease risk so they can be targeted and changed to help decrease disease in the future. When all is said and done, the information gathered from this project will go a long way to ensuring the longevity of these farms and improving the pigs' health. And that is the big squeal. Thank you.